Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a very quick look at a couple of questions that involve converting units of time. So looking at this first example, we want to change 180 minutes into hours. So the first thing we want to do is find our unit conversion between the units that we've been given, which in this first example are minutes and hours. So we use our unit conversion that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So the reason we find our unit conversion is to help us understand what we have to do when we're converting from one to another. So to get from 1 hour to 60 minutes, I'm simply multiplying by 60, as 1 times 60 gives me 60. And then if I wanted to get from minutes back to hours, I'd divide by 60, because 60 divided by 60 is going to get me back to 1. So now we know which calculations we have to do. To get from hours to minutes, we have to multiply by 60. And to get from minutes to hours, we simply have to divide by 60. So again, for this first example, we want to change 180 minutes into hours. And then using our unit conversion, we know to get from minutes to hours, we have to divide by 60. So we're simply going to do 180 divided by 60. Well, I can simplify that fraction by dividing top and bottom by 10. So that's the same as 18 divided by 6, which then gives me 3. So 180 minutes is the same as 3 hours. And we can use our unit conversion for our next question as well. This time we want to change 5 hours into minutes. So I'm going to take my 5 hours, and looking back at my unit conversion, to get from hours to minutes, we're multiplying by 60. So we're simply going to do 5 times by 60. Well, that actually gives us 300. So 5 hours in minutes would simply be 300 minutes. So that's something we can do with any unit conversion question. We can draw a little diagram like this, just to help us better understand what calculations we actually need to do. So let's now have a look at some practice questions. So feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. So for this first question, we want to change 1 hour into seconds. Well, we know from our unit conversion that we just did a minute ago that 1 hour is equivalent to 60 minutes. But because we want our answer in seconds, we now need to look at our next unit conversion. So we know that there are 60 minutes in 1 hour, and we also know in 1 minute, there are 60 seconds. So we've got another unit conversion there as well. So we said we know in 1 hour there are 60 minutes. So I'm going to take them 60 minutes and I want to convert them into seconds. So from our second unit conversion, we can get from 1 minute to 60 seconds by multiplying by 60. And we can get from seconds to minutes by dividing by 60. So we actually want to convert these 60 minutes into seconds now. So to go from minutes to seconds, we actually have to multiply by 60. So if we do 60 multiplied by 60, that's going to give us 3,600. So in 1 hour, there are 3,600 seconds. And we've done that by simply applying the rules of two unit conversions. For this next question, we need to change 2.5 hours to minutes. So we could follow our rule again of getting from hours to minutes. We have to simply multiply by 60, so I could do 2.5 multiplied by 60. But we're actually going to do this question another way. We know from our unit conversion that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So I'm going to use that now to find the times that I need. So I need 2.5 hours. So let's start with the 2 hours. Well, we know from our original unit conversion that 1 hour is equivalent to 60 minutes. So to find 2 hours, we're simply going to times both sides by 2. So that must mean that 2 hours is equal to 120 minutes. Now I want to find what a half hour would be in minutes. Well, again, these are very common ones that we do learn, but we can find them from the original unit conversion, because if an hour is 60 minutes, then to find half an hour, I've just divided that by 2. So a half an hour is equivalent to 30 minutes. So now to get the total, I'm just simply going to add these together. So 2.5 hours would be the sum of 120 minutes plus 30 minutes. Well, if I add them two numbers together, that's going to give me 150 minutes. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple more questions. So again, just like before, feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first question, we want to work out the difference in minutes between 40 minutes and 1.25 hours. So because we want to give our answer in minutes, we want to find out what both of these times are in minutes. So the first one has been given for us. We're already given 40 minutes. So all we need to do now is convert this second time into just minutes as well. So we've got 1.25 hours. Well, we know that 1 hour from our unit conversion is equivalent to 60 minutes. And then we've got 1/4 hour. So again, this is a very common one that we learn, but if we do forget, we can use our unit conversion to figure it out. To find 1/4 hour, I'm simply going to take my hour and divide it by 4. So if I do that with the minutes as well, I'd have 60 divided by 4, that's going to give me 15 minutes. So now 1.25 hours is just going to be the sum of these two. So if I add these two together, I get 75 minutes. So 1.25 hours is equivalent to 75 minutes. So now I need to find the difference between my 40 minutes and this new 75 minutes we figured out. So to find the difference, I'm going to take my largest number, which is 75, and I'm going to take away my smallest, which is 40. So if we do that, we've got 5 take away 0 is 5, 7 take away 4 is 3. So the difference between 40 minutes and 1.25 hours is just 35 minutes. And that's my final answer for that one. Okay, and for this very last question, we want to work out the difference, again in minutes, between 3 hours 35 minutes and 1.75 hours. So I'm going to start with this 3 hour and 35 minutes. Well, we know that 1 hour, again, is equal to 60 minutes. So to find 3 hours, we're simply going to multiply it by 3. So if I do that with the minutes as well, I'd have 180 minutes. So we know that 3 hours is 180 minutes. I'm then going to add on the remaining 35 minutes. And if I do that, I get 0 add 5, which gives me 5, 8 add 3, which gives me 11. So 1, carry 1, and then 1, add the 1 I've just carried, gives me 2. So this is actually equal to 215 minutes. We're now going to look at our 1.75 hours. Well, again, we know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. We now want to figure out what 3/4 hour is. Well, again, this is another common one that we do learn, but if we do forget, we can figure out 1/4 hour by just dividing our hour by 4, which means we do the same with the minutes. So 60 divided by 4 would give me 15. So if 1/4 hour is 15 minutes, I can simply find 3/4 hour by multiplying it by 3. So I do that with the minutes as well. 15 multiplied by 3 is going to give me 45 minutes. So to find this combination of 1.75 hours, I'm going to take my 1 hour and my 3/4 hours. I'm going to take the minutes, which are 60 and 45, and I'm simply just going to add them together. So that gives me 0 add 5, which is 5, 6 add 4, which is 10. So this time would be equivalent to 105 minutes. So we now want to find our difference between 215 minutes and 105 minutes. So we're simply going to do our 215 take away this 105. So doing that, I've got 5 take away 5, which is 0, 1 take away 0, which is 1, and 2 take away 1, which is also 1. So the difference between 3 hours and 35 minutes and 1.75 hours in minutes would just be 110. And that would be my final answer to that question. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.